Welcome to the final module. Now, in this module, we're going to discuss how the money machine works, how our construction investment trust operates. Any mom or pop entrepreneur can come up with an idea. Even a small group of entrepreneurs can come up with an idea. And what generally happens in the crypto and blockchain space is someone writes a white paper, creates a website, builds a small team, adds a few advisors, and goes out and tries to raise a whole bunch of money for their idea. The idea has not been tested. It's never been executed before from them. They do not have strong expertise in the ability to execute this idea before. There's been no real field work in order to execute this idea before. And what happens is that you have a bunch of people trying something new and a whole bunch of people funding it with the hopes that it is going to become successful. And that is why 95% of all ICOs, regardless of if they raise money or not, fail. Because they can't get their product to market. They've never been on the receiving end of knowing what to do with the money even when they raise it. And so it may look like a whole bunch of amazing success, but at the end of the day, it is not executable. And anything that is not executable is not scalable. And so I'm gonna break down for you our entire CIT model. Why CIT? Why a construction investment trust? You know, one of the cool reasons is that you've probably never ever even heard of one. You didn't even know they existed until now. And the third thing is, why Habibi? And so I'm going to break down for you why we're so confident at what we're doing. And like I mentioned before, anyone can come up with an idea. And generally in the blockchain space, there is a system and process to things. The blockchain is built on a system and process. And things have to happen at certain times and places inside that process in order for it to be successful. Same thing with the construction industry. If you're trying to build a villa, you're trying to build a high-rise tower, it doesn't matter what you're trying to build. There is a process to it that you have to map out in advance. There is a complete breakdown. And as we explained earlier in the breakdown of the construction of a villa project, you know, we have basically what we call a 3P formula. And this 3P formula is the reason we are so confident in what we're doing. And I'm going to explain to you the 3P formula. And the first thing, we've spent a lot of modules and videos with you going over some of this stuff and explaining to you our entire model so that you are educated enough to know how things work, whether you're a part of the construction industry, whether you've ever invested into real estate, whether you've ever invested into real estate-backed token like ours, or whether you have, you know, never done any of these things and are just coming into it for the first time and you do not even know how to set up your ERC-20 compatible wallet. So first step, the first P in the 3P formula is planning. We've gone through a lot of videos with you guys explaining our entire planning process. Now, we mentioned a villa, constructing a villa, and when you're constructing a villa, you have the planning process that goes through it. You have your phase one, which we talked about, your phase two, your phase three. Each phase has its own time duration inside that phase. It has the amount of days that you're doing specific activities down to the timing that each activity has to be done. And then you have what the result is from the efforts of that one phase and those things being done on time, interwoven, connected together to get this one result. Then from there, you go to the next phase and then the next phase. And then through all the five, six phases, you have your completed product, your finished product, your success, your results. You have that winning point that you put on the board for completing that villa or completing that construction project. Well, our CIT model for Habibi Coin works in the exact same way. There is a whole system and process, not just for one project. As we broke down to you, there's a system and process for multiple projects, and I'm talking hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of projects. And when you have a sound system and process, which you're always tweaking and efficientizing and making improvements on, you know, it runs better and better and better. Do you know why McDonald's is one of the most successful companies in the world? Or why Subway is one of the most successful companies in the world? Because they may be giving you fast food. They may be giving you food in a very fast time frame. But they have a step-by-step franchise model for them to be able to serve you a burger in under 3 minutes. You know, they have it being run by pimple-faced teenagers who are prone to human error, and yet you know, it runs efficiently because they have a step-by-step franchise processed model that has been tested and trialed over and over, and they have real-world experience on being able to scale that model. So then all they do is create another franchise, put more young kids in there, one good manager, and start serving burgers to the world. And McDonald's has sold over hundreds of billions of burgers to people. Keep this in mind, there's 7.6 billion people on the planet. So almost every single person has eaten a McDonald's hamburger because of their system and process and their franchise system and process that they've continuously improved. Now, a CIT works the same way. We have internally a great system and process that we're constantly improving, that we're constantly efficientizing. And the beauty of this is that the bigger it gets, the less expensive it gets, the more profitable it becomes. And so this all is due to the planning. You have to plan for your success. So the first part is making sure your planning is down, and I mean down to the T. And the second part, and I'll explain a little bit about our planning. So we have our sourcing process for getting all of our laborers, all of our skilled workers. We have our process to making sure they love the company that they work for and they're willing to give it their all. They're willing to stick around for the long haul. Then we have our process for what it takes in order for us to start a project, how much money has to be on hand, at what phase and stages we can start these completions, and what times and phases we start realizing our profits. The amazing thing about a construction investment trust, a construction-based model, is that profits are realized month to month to month to month, phase to phase to phase to phase. And that's amazing because there's not many ideas or companies out there that will start generating cash flow immediately. A lot of the other ideas out there and things like that, you have to build something. It has to materialize. You need to get buyers. You need to get users. You need to get a community behind it. And then when that starts scaling, you start making money. With the construction model, you have to have enough just to start, and as you complete, you make money, and then you start the next phase, you complete, and you make money. And you're making cash flow all throughout the model. And so, planning, we have it on lock. We have it down. Then, when we're ready through infrastructure, through equipment, through skilled labor, to be able to complete projects on time and on budget, and I'm talking multiple projects running at one time, and knowing all the logistics needed to be able to manage this type of operation, then it falls into our second P. And our second P inside this formula is partnerships. This is heavily reliant on partnerships, because we can have all the planning and the labor and the know-how and the experience in the world, but if we don't have projects steady in the pipeline continuously coming to us, then we can't scale this construction investment trust. We can't scale this model and generate more and more profits, because our profits are not generated on one project. Our profits are generated on continuously doing projects and reapplying the same economics and labor and the planning to the second project. So when you have the full planning down and you have a pipeline of projects and you're applying the same efficiency, the same planning to each project in consecutiveness with the next project, and you have a very disciplined approach to basically tackling more and more and more projects, you can scale infinitely. You can scale infinitely because you have all the infrastructure and the system to be able to do that. And if you don't, and you get more projects than you can handle, most people would think that's amazing. I have more projects than I can handle. But if you can't handle them, it's very destructive. It actually ends up becoming your own destruction. It ends up doing you up because you can't then manage it. Any sudden influx of responsibility, time, money, freedom or anything like that generally is a stressful thing on the human mind because we have not been prepared or trained or conditioned to manage it. But if you have been and you get that sudden influx and you're responsible enough to be able to manage it, you can take it to the moon. You can take it to the next level completely. And so partnerships are a very strong part of our 3P formula. And our partnerships, as we discussed earlier in some of the modules, we had around 4 or 5 signed agreements. We are at 9 now. We have 9 partnerships on board, and probably by the time you're done watching this video, we'll have basically probably another 15 in total, another 6 in total, so 15 on board. And as I mentioned earlier in our model, that each consultant that sits on our board provides us roughly 10 to 15 projects. We had 3 providing us 50. And so the pipeline is growing. The pipeline is building. These partnerships that we are creating are being nurtured. They're being built upon. There's relationships being grown and together, and we are starting to understand our consultants' needs further, and they are starting to understand our project planning and our ability to execute even further. And as we commit on these projects and we start to deliver, this will create a much deeper relationship with the consultants, and they will then be eager to provide us more projects over any other contractor that they have that they do business with, because we will deliver again on time, on budget, and we will make sure their money doesn't get stuck and they're super happy. And now when you compound that, you have partnerships in there and you're signing more and more partnerships. Originally, we only needed 10 partnerships. When we had discussed the model that we had created in the past videos, we only needed 10 partnerships in order for us to do 100 to 150 projects. We're not going to stop at 10 partnerships. There's 665 consultants in the city of Dubai. And so we are going to push until we have about 25, 30 consultants on board so that we have our ability to be selective on the consultant we want to work with, the project that we want to focus on, you know. And we gave you a breakdown of just one villa, a 1 million villa with a 30% margin of profit with the retention and then other costs that are factored in. But we didn't tell you if it was a 5 million dirham villa, if it was a 2.5 million dirham villa, if it was a 60, 70 million dirham low-rise building, you know, or different things like that. So we kept it very conservative. But partnerships, strong partnerships with steady deal flow constantly coming in is the second biggest P to our crucial formula of success. And the third part, the final P in this 3P formula is profit sharing. This is where our community members get extremely happy for all the hard work that we're putting in and the thought to create this amazing system and process that we've tried and tested and put together. And also, we're happy. The company is happy. The employees are happy. Everyone is happy because there is profit being created and profit being shared. To give you a great idea at the fact that we know exactly what we're doing, and we invite you to bring us your question, bring us your challenges, you know, have some certain level of skepticism or anything like that about our model so we can explain things to you in a deeper way. We want you to be believers, Habibers, you know, if that's even a coin-termed phrase out there. And in order for us to do that, you know, you have to first go through our model, understand it, and then have some curiosity to ask us questions so we can explain it to you further. And you may just keep us on our toes even further. We've planned so far ahead that, you know, we're very confident at what we're doing here. But I'm going to break it down for you further so you understand it. So far I've explained why a construction investment trust, why Habibi Coin. I've explained the 3P formula. Now I'm going to get into a little bit more of a deeper explanation. You know, and that's explaining our cost breakdown. So I'm going to explain to you our cost breakdown per employee. Every single person who is working in our company, you know, has a cost breakdown. We know what they're costing us over a two-year period. And when that is fully broken down and you understand what it costs for us to have one employee in this company working full-time, and you compound that, then you'll see, again, our second part, which is project breakdown plus profit. So we'll show you, Dubai Municipality has a mandate, you have to have five laborers per project. And so a minimum of five laborers per project. And so when you have five laborers and they're doing one project, and I explain to you all the costs involved in making this labor work for 2 years and all the costs involved for running this project until completion, and then you see both costs involved and the profit generated from there, then you will clearly understand, you know, how much work our labor can do in what time frame and how profitable that is to us as a construction investment trust. Then I will explain to you our construction investment trust compounding model. Everybody knows compound and compounding is generally the most magical thing in the world, except most compounding is generated off interest. We don't compound anything off interest. We compound it based on real business. So we compound the construction. And anything, any formula that you can add in compounding to anything from business to products and services to even construction, then it generally creates an amazing opportunity for you to scale it beyond an unimaginable scale. And so I'm going to go through the compounding model. And then finally, I'm going to touch on our tokenomics model and our buybacks. Why are we so confident the token price will go up? Why are we so confident that if you buy into our pre-ICO, ICO, you will generate a great return? Again, it has everything to do with the fact of the construction investment trust and the model and our cost breakdown, project breakdown, and our profit generated. and then the compounding that takes place, and then the tokenomics. And the tokenomics are very simple. Bitcoin, there's only 21 million Bitcoins in the world. And so the more people that want to buy some, the more that are mined, the more the value of them go up, because it's simple economics of supply and demand. And so in Habibi coin, there's also a limited number of Habibi coins. And the more profitable the underlying businesses and investments are of Habibi coin's business models, the more the value of them go up from the business model itself, which generates more interest from the public. And the public then wants to increase the demand to purchase, and the supply becomes less and less and less, driving the value of the tokens up. And then what can we do as, you know, the management over here to increase this, to kickstart this even more? And so we have what we call a token buyback program. Some of the profits that are generated from our cash flowing construction business are reinvested into purchasing tokens from our community and burning them. And what that does is, if there's, you know, as an example, 2 billion tokens on the market and 200 million, which is 10%, was purchased and burnt, the remaining 1.8 billion in supply, the supply decreases. So the remaining supply ends up being worth more. And so anyone who is holding on to their tokens for the long term is going to generate a higher and higher year-on-year return. In some cases, quarter-on-quarter, and in our case, from the construction phase-to-phase return, which is absolutely amazing. And so I'm going to break down the model. Let's start with the cost breakdown. Let's break down one employee cost.